For the first time since the pandemic, a Philippine delegation led by the Trade Department holds an investment roadshow in several European countries. The DTI says this aims to highlight the Philippines as a viable investment destination for European investors. Sectors such as manufacturing, research and development, and renewable energy will be given priority. The European Investment Roadshow kicked off on June 18, which will be in France, Belgium, the United Kingdom, the Netherlands, and Germany until July 6. The Philippines' outstanding external debt hits a record high of $118 billion in the first quarter. Preliminary data from the central bank showed external debt climbed by 8.3% from the previous $109.8 billion recorded year on year. According to the BSP, the rise was driven primarily by the statistical adjustment involving the inclusion of the non-resident holdings of peso-denominated debt securities, which were issued onshore in the debt stock. Now, the growth was also impelled by net availments of the national government, prior periods adjustments, and the appreciation of other currencies against the U.S. dollar. Despite the rise, though, the central bank notes the country's external debt ratio remains at a prudent level. The Philippine Central Bank posts a net loss of 1.4 billion pesos in the first quarter of the year. The BSP recognized 11 billion in net losses from foreign exchange rate fluctuations in 2022. That's a reversal of the 17.46 billion in net gains last year. The BSP posted revenues of 38.55 billion pesos, a 7.4% drop from the previous year. Revenues mostly came from interest income on foreign investments and government securities. Meanwhile, expenses more than doubled to 49.63 billion pesos. Overall, the central bank's net worth stood at 143.75 billion pesos at the end of the first quarter, and that's higher than the 98.51 billion pesos clocked in the previous year. Here at home, the mega consortium seeking to rehabilitate Manila's main gateway unveils its multi-phase development master plan for the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Lady Vicencio is on the line for more. Hi, Lady. What can you tell us so far about the master plan?
Stanley, the six conglomerates comprising the Manila International Airport Consortium unveiled its master plan for the rehabilitation and development of the country's main gateway, the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. The 267 billion peso proposal includes a 57 billion peso concession agreement to the government, which is the largest upfront concession payment in the country, according to the consortium. The master plan's value includes 211 billion pesos of capital investment. A 25-year concession period is proposed to implement the master plan's three phases aimed to double the NAIA's passenger capacity from the current 31 million passengers per annum to 70 million passengers by 2048. The consortium's technical partner, infrastructure investor, and airport operator Global Infrastructure Partners says the rehabilitation is timely as NAIA is projected to hit 67 million passengers per year by 2044. Developments will include additional airfield capacities and expansion of terminal space and airfield capacity, which the consortium sees as the long-term solution to air traffic congestion and other operational issues in the NAIA. The MIAC also expressed confidence to transform NAIA as a driver of economic growth as the government markets the Philippines as a tourism hub. With the planned development and billions of investments for the beach, the consortium also hinted on an increase in terminal fees, but committed that the rates will not be higher than the current market rates. Aside from the concession payment of 57 billion pesos, the government is expected to receive an additional 280 billion pesos from revenue sharing and taxes during the 25-year concession period. The MIAC has yet to hear from the Department of Transportation after submitting their unsolicited proposal last April. A Boises Infra Capital president and CEO Cosette Canilao said that they are ready to implement the rehabilitation within the year should the DOTR grant the project to the mega consortium. Stanley?
All right, thank you so much for the update, Lady Vicentro.